ages. So first of all, we're talking to one of the best trainers in the history of boxing, Nazim Richardon. Nazim, how are you feeling today?
Holding on both hands. I'm blessed by the best, and I'm still a mess.
You sound good. You look good. You're feeling good. You're here with Travis Kaufman. Travis is a veteran. He fought everybody under the book, and now he's fighting big, bad King Kong Ortiz.
Listen, Deontay Wilder right now is the number one heavyweight in the game. The number two heavyweight is King Kong. If you got anything to say about it, you got to see one of those two. Tyson Fury got something to say about it, so he's going to see Deontay Wilder.
What do you think happens in that fight?
Oh, well, like I said, it's boxing. Tyson got himself in great shape. He battled his demons, and now he's trying to battle Deontay. I mean, just don't want nobody to come out hurt. And they both get their bread and do what they say. And like I said, Fury is a mover, a shaker. He might get away with that for a while. But Lord have mercy, Deontay close in on that.
It's good night.
Yeah, it's good weekend. That's where that joke upon.
I got to ask you this. Mikey Garcia, Errol Spence, what's your take on that fight?
I keep telling people that's two great fighters, great fight. I know that James and Spence people are not going there, so Mikey. See, the rest of the world is going in there with this Mikey just small. Spence going to smack him. Spence going to come prepared because that's how he do all the time. He like, man, I know if this guy get three rounds in, they'll celebrate it. You know what I mean? I know anything Mikey does that ain't fall in the first round is a plus one. You know what I mean? But we know Mikey ain't gave nothing away easy. I made a statement earlier about saying that Mikey's like a Latino Mayweather. When my son was reading me some of the comments, these people start commenting like I was saying that he fights like Floyd Mayweather. And I was like, the people who don't understand that, why are they on these boxing websites? Mikey was raised in the culture of boxing.
From age zero, he was born into it.
Like Floyd. That's the reference I'm making. Even, I didn't think I had to spell that out for people who watch these websites. I thought they knew boxing. And he doesn't fight anything like Floyd. Mike says he fights like Floyd. I said one time that Mike Tyson was the fastest for heavyweight, hand speed and foot speed since Ali. He doesn't fight like Ali. I said, why you people even reading what I say? I'm in the box. Go do something else. Yeah, but Mikey was raised in a high culture, a high level.
High boxing IQ.
High boxing IQ. And everybody around him, Robert, his granddaddy, everything around him.
It's his dad.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, his daddy, they're just phenomenal guys when it comes to this sport. And naturally, they pass it on. You know what I mean? So
Mikey has similarities to Floyd, but not in the fighting style.
No, he doesn't have similarities physically in any capacity to me.
Yeah.
He has similarity in being raised. He has similarity in being raised around boxing. He's been around championship level boxing and thinking.
And they were?
Before he knew his alphabet.
That's true.
Yeah, I mean, he was hearing words like feint and jab and double up and defense. Before he really knew his ABCs.
It's in his DNA.
Yeah.
Okay, so what about the fight itself? How do you see it unfolding?
I really can't pick. If I was forced, if you pulled the gun, I'd say you got to pick somebody. Really. I got to go to Spence. The advantage of being a bigger man, not just being bigger, but being an outstanding fighter. And it's the old cliche of a good big man can beat a good little. It comes to that conversation.
That's true. How about this? Adrian Broner, who you know from the amateurs, I'm sure. Manny Pacquiao, who you know you coached against him.
Oh, my God.
What do you think right now? I mean, it's a very interesting fight.
You can't pick fights with A.B., man. Because A.B. is the cliche of we know what he's capable of, but is he going to do it that day? Yeah, I mean, what he's capable of, yeah, is he capable of beating Pacquiao? Perhaps, because he got the skill set to beat anybody. Will he bring that package to the table? That's what we got to find. That's why we got to watch the fight and see what happens. I'm glad to see him get this kind of opportunity. I'm glad to see the resurgence of Pacquiao, man.
He looked good against Matisse?
Phenomenal, man. Matisse is a tough guy. He hit Matisse with a jab in the first round. It looked like Matisse never recovered from that jab.
It's true. And then I'm gonna ask you one more fight. Canelo, I know you've always been a big supporter of his. You always believed in him. You saw him as a young kid when he was with Shane up there. Did they spar ever?
No, they didn't.
But they fought.
Yeah, they fought.
What do you think about how Canelo's growing and now with 365 million and he's a two division going for his third division championship?
Canelo's doing the damn thing, man. He learned well, and that fight with Floyd taught him a lot about boxing, and he is applying. You know what I mean? He's doing the thing. Shout out to him and that deal he got from his own.
It's crazy. It's a lot of money.
Yeah, anybody chopping at it is just hating. I tell my sons, you know, if you're hating on what you're talking about, if they paid you to do it, you said yes.
Of course, no, I'm not hating. I'm impressed because that means that boxing is the most relevant sport, highest sports contract ever.
So he's doing his thing, man. And he'll work for it. Somebody give you a job like that.
Of course.
He'll work for it. And someday he's going to do the super middleweight now, right? There's some guys up there. I just saw a kid fight Saturday that said he can make super middleweight as easy as light heavyweight. The kid be wrong. He said he can make super middleweight. So, man, who wouldn't want to see Canelo and Bivol? It's a fight.
Yeah. Let me ask you this. What is Floyd Mayweather's secret of success? To me, he's the best fighter of our era because I've seen him do so good against 26 champions.
He's proven. He's proven. And if we all knew the secret, see, like I'm saying, I'm too busy watching what you do to hear what you say. If we all knew the secret, then shit, he wouldn't be the only one doing it.
So he has something special.
Yeah, like I say, he was raised with an IQ of boxing from birth at a high level. There's plenty of people born into a boxing family, but he was raised at a high level of boxing. You know what I mean, and he stayed disciplined, he stayed focused. It's easy to get caught up. You know what I mean, he stayed focused.
Message to your fan Nazim people who love you and support you if they're watching from Philly to the rest of the world.
Like I said, I'm blessed by the best, but I'm still a mess. I'm going to take small steps. I can take big ones, man. And like I said, to everybody, man, just take care of your, pray your families are healthy. And you put them on the right track and you walk the right track with them. And just everybody, like I said, celebrate this era of boxing. Because it ain't half bad.
I got one business question. When a fighter says that he's fighting for $1 million, Nazim, how much does he actually take home? Does he go home with $1 million? Does he go home with half? Does he go...
Depending on the fighter.
Okay.
And the deal that he has. But ain't nobody going home with that whole million.
First of all, there's tax. So yeah, half is off the table, right?
And there's people you got to pay if he pays them.
Your coach? Then, if he gets... Because the coach is the last one to get paid. I know that.
Oh, man. So
you have to chase a check.
And some of these fighters, man...
They don't pay.
They'll take the money from the... They'll take the camp expenses and pay everybody. That's how little they're paying everybody. They'll take the camp expenses and pay everybody.
20% manager, 10% coach, other camp expenses. So you're not left with $1 million. You're left with $300,000, $400,000.
If that's been out of the game. You see, like I say, some of these fighters, they're going to make sure they cover it, man. They pay you maybe. You know what I mean?
That's true. There you have it, Nazim Richardson. Well, good luck with Travis Kaufman against King Kong. It's a tough fight, but this is boxing.
It's tough fights are right here. It's two steps above that. It's that kind of fight. But listen, if you're not up for the task, you know what I mean? Don't win your ass.
Hey, what do they say? If you can't take the heat, stay out of the kitchen.
That's it. This young boy, like I said, the one thing you saw in the press conference,
yep,
wasn't no BS.
No.
He ain't afraid of nobody. Ain't nobody walk around with gloves on he afraid of. You know what I mean?
That's true. But I remember him fighting like Chris Arreola. He's been around for a long time.
He took his chin and rumble. Sometimes we got to make sure he stayed the game plan.
Yeah.
Because he took his chin
excited
and started rumbling. You know?
That's true. All right, Nazim Richardson, Travis Kaufman right here. Tyson Fury, Wilder card. FuseWithPoint.com. We'll be back reporting.